In New York, downtown is more than a zip code. It's a place for the free exchange of ideas, where forms and definitions are undone on a nightly basis. It's where magic happens. The place for music downtown is the Knitting Factory.
As a violinist, as a band leader, and as a composer, Leroy Jenkins presents the entire span of American music. Only someone with his fluency could expand the language as he has. This is Leroy Jenkins' Gut Band.
Thank you. of carrying on the tradition of improvisational music, you know. And but the music is all, you know, with that branch, we learned how to, we sought to put the music in a context where the person would know where he's coming, going, where he's coming from, and where he's going. You know? So I mean, and then the improvisation in between. If you know where you're coming from, where you're going, I mean, you feel pretty safe, even though there's no net between the two. There's no net between, but at least you know you're going there, you know? David here, who's probably is the youngest of the group, he's now a freshman at Juilliard. He's a real fine bassist. There was a party where there were parents and it was a birthday party. Was it your brother's birthday?
Yeah.
Yeah, his brother's birthday party. And I had just come from a gig. I was in Albany and I had my instrument and everything, so I didn't want to go home because it would be a hassle. So I went to the party and parked all my stuff in the clothes room. And when I was, you know, I noticed there was a bass there. And after a while, somebody introduced me to David here. You know, so I said, you know, and I somehow or another heard about him. So I said, yeah. He said, oh, I said, well, that was your bass I saw in the clothes. He said, yeah. I said, so it was. I wanted to kind of get away anyway. So I said, let's go back in the back, you know. Check it out. So we went back in the clothes room there, and he took his bass out. I took my violin out. We just started playing. Yeah. So we played a little while there. So I said, yeah. I thought, you know, I mean, for him to do that, I mean, it's very rare. I mean, most times, they want to play some kind of standard tune or something like that. But, you know, me being like I am, I just kind of started off playing, you know, and he just kind of went right along with it. Yeah.
working in the quartet with Leroy recently, it's another, it brings another thing out of the guitar, you know, what I'm being asked to do. So there's always, depending on whose perspective I'm looking from, different composers, I discover something new about the instrument in solving the creative problems or challenges of the music, and then bringing that to the guitar in such a way so that it speaks and it's gestural and it comes alive. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Each instrument brings a different aspect to the complete picture, and in order for it to harmonize or harmoniumize, it's got to be a certain, you know, in order to get the sound, you have to put the notes at a certain place, you know, the notes have to be put at a certain place for them to come out, I mean, the way you want to. And then you got to think about the instruments. Then you got to think about the person, you know, if they can do it, you know, stuff like that.
I really feel he's a national treasure.
Oh,
and,
okay.
And just what, the way he creates his music, and David and Newman and I, we were in rehearsal last week, and Leroy had forgotten some of his music, so he was conducting us through the pieces. And we had rehearsed them in a particular way, and then we got in, and he was conducting them, and bringing us in, and I kept looking up, and I said, well, Leroy, you know, we don't have a visa to your planet for that, so you really have to, like, really show us what it is. It's just a very personal and rare.
Studio on Houston and Broadway, and I was hustling to try to make money, so I had a sign out for students, you know, and I'd have them come up, and I'd write music for them, and they'd play it, and we'd, you know, jam all, you know, that, all day and stuff like that. And so I got quite a few people. Myra Melford came up during that time.
Yeah.
Marion Brandis. And Terry Genua, she was there, you know, and Terry Genua. So we had, it was really nice. I was just writing this music, and then after a while, I just wrote enough music. So I formed a sextet on most of them. And with most of the guys, it was two guitars, two violins, bass and drums. Yeah. Call ourselves Sting. In fact, I didn't know about Sting when I named it. And so a couple of times we played gigs and people thought that we were Sting. They came in and were like, the place is packed, boy.
Yeah, I love that.
We showed up, but they were polite. They waited, we played one number, man. They started going up. They started walking out in droves, man.